and that's going to help you get past the fall. So, almost like a little puzzle. There's another monster I gotta face here. All right, so now we gotta find a blue tree. Right here. In case you got. How the hell did you get past these areas? That's it. Going around here, because apparently there's... I'm still doing the Code Red hunts. And apparently there's a monster here. Right here, the serial killer tree. In one of these areas that's not letting me see. I gotta, like, do the area for myself before it reveals it. There's the target. Ain't getting past this way. That's all right. All right. I guess we're gonna need a red fruit to get past him. Breakable wall. Gotta be a way to get around there. Hold on. Oh, here we go. You know, I need a blue fruit to get by. Doubt they have a tree close by, so I gotta go back. In fact, let me just try it, because they probably got a tree by. Close by. I probably just gotta look. Not enough. But just to get a cat's box. Hello, food. Yeah, I can't. But it was rare fumes. On top of that, I said, can't. There anyway. Guess we gotta get some energy flowing in this area. Let's see if I can. Oh, it's right there though. Head back the other way. He was over there. Maybe they gotta wait for us to get this energy flowing so I can reach my target. And yellow fruit. Just had that damn thing too. Where's that yellow shriek? Down here? Yellow! Now we can ride this. Red fruit. It would be better if I, yeah, you know what? Let's go back to the entrance. Oh, here we go. Hello, what's this? Red rosemary. One, two, three, and we got our target. I wonder if this, if you gotta do like special things to get the other ones. Here, freshers. Hey, it's not showing. All right, this one gone. But I need to just say this. Before I started recording, I went back to Tail. I went back to Tailson, and I did like all the little exclamation point events. And apparently, Zavid, there's an event with Zavid where I think I can go back and I can face that dragon. That was here. I think it was the Stone Mountain Peaks. I'm not sure. But I know I can face the dragon. I just gotta finish the V side quest, and then I can go to Hex Island. I can go to Hex Island again. I'm gonna try doing that. Mountain Peak, right there. Hopefully that dragon is right there and I ain't wasting my time. Feet over there.
I can't wait to take a good look around. Whoa, now that's what I call a view.
I agree that it's beautiful, but don't leap about so much. You'll fall. I can sense many earth pulses under this place.
I figured you'd notice that. An intricate web of earth pulses crisscrosses the land under the Aldina Plains. Mountains like these would normally take tens of thousands of years to form, but these popped up in about a millennia.
So the earth pulses have affected the land?
Exactly. Long ago, people wielded arts that allowed them to manipulate the earth pulses and control the very land itself.
How could arts like that exist?
Perhaps they pushed against key points on the earth pulses?
That's a rather forced comparison. Either way, those arts have been lost for eons.
I'm impressed, Aizen. You know a lot about everything.
Not at all. There's so much I don't know. For example, the name of these flowers. That's why I travel.
Aldina Alabaster Grass.
That's the name of this flower?
Yes. A long time ago. But they're fragile flowers. They die quickly on their own. But if enough of them gather together, they can survive. Fields of them form beautiful white carpets of flowers. In some cultures, they symbolize kinship.
Kinship.
I'll remember that. You and your brother.
I'll never forget either.
Okay, so where's the dragon? Planes. I don't want to go back. that one area I haven't discovered yet. I'd rather haven't been to. It's right down there, and I'm finna head there right now. I don't know if last time I just couldn't go, or they just didn't let me enter it. Like, I couldn't. Hopefully we can go through here. No, I know it's a place we haven't visited yet. Let me look up how to pass this. The ball grows out. Explaining the side quest. I got that. Where is the side quest? I don't even know who to obtain permission from. Alright, just give me a minute. Oh, great. One of those typed up. Okay, so let's see. It's like a. I probably gonna go back to Tailsin. Right here. Supposedly there's a church right here. Wasn't aware. Okay, I guess we found out where that is. So we just gotta go down. It's that side quest that I started. But, the V. Priest right here.
Come, sinner, and repent your...
Are you talking to me?
Yes, you, with those eyes that would belong on the Reaper's face. I...
Oh?
I'm sorry for bothering you, sir. If you don't have anything you need to confess, that's fine.
No, actually, there is one thing I'd like to get off my chest.
Of course. Go right on ahead.
This all happened a long time ago. But this turtle's brought over a painting by the master artist Beryl Beneath. It was a gorgeous work of art. Only later, I found...
So, you want to repent?
No. Buying it was my decision. Even if the painting itself was fake.
What are you going on?
Did you say something?
No.
The truth is, when I saw that painting, so I... swiped 100. That's
fear not, my son. No matter what the Empyreans made,
I hope so.
Come, sinner.
Do you mean
yes?
Suppose I was supposed to.
No.
I was supposed to talk to him until Bienfu said something to him.
Not to. And I read in. I wanted to.
So you sprinkled salt on the slug, but. If the experience taught you to respect...
No, that's not what I messed up, and I put sugar on the... And then...
Ugh. It's okay. I forgive...
There's... I wanted to see what would happen if I poured sugar water down an anthill.
Kids can sure be... Come,
yes, Father.
No, I wasn't talking to you, truly. The sinners are those people you're with. Who come into this cathedral?
No, Father. For instance, I once put blind, unquestioning faith in the Abbey's. In making any decision, I used not my head. I lorded my authority over those I thought to be below me.
What?
I was telling other people how to live their life. But I won't repent for my. I will follow my own judgment.
Please, Lady Exorcist, listen to my.
Huh?
Come, sinner.
There we go.
Because everyone else in your group has been nothing but trouble. Not a single one of them will truly repent. What kind of place do they think this holy sanctuary is?
I don't know what to tell you. You'll have to take it up with them.
I can't. You know what they're like, right? If I complain about it to them, they'll just beat the stuffing out of me.
I wish I could tell you that deep down they're all good people, but...
That's why you need to confess something.
What? Why me?
Please, I just want to hear a legitimate confession for once. If you don't hurry up, I'll put a curse on you.
Oh, all right. I'm so sorry for all the trouble that my companions have caused you, Father.
No, that's not going to work. I guess I'm not quite in the mood to forgive that yet.
Alright, so apparently that was one side quest, and there was a girl near the exit, apparently. I think I already got the girl near the exit. I think I did that earlier. Suppose there's a ladder and a rare board somewhere around. not right there. Probably a way for me to get up there. What? That didn't work? Okay. How do I get back there? Now I'm starting to get confused. Here we go. Know what I'm doing, but it looks like we're just making matches. Thank you. Oh, so we're trying to match up the games that they come from. Oh, okay, I see. I get it now. Like you're trying to match up the games that the characters come from. Oh, wow, it seems like you play this, it's like it's all based on luck. Hey, how is he pulling from that decker? I can do that. Wait, he's drawing from that. How do I do that? That's all that was about. figured this was going to be a lot easier, and I was just trying to get past that thing. I didn't want to do like a whole list of side quests. Up the ladder board to the cats. Where's the cats? Right here? I was to go to the leaderboard. What the? We gotta go to the tavern. I was in a tavern. I'm in an inn.
People have been saying that the Lord of Calamity destroyed Mercia.
Well, Mercia wasn't destroyed. All the people were driven out. How are other towns holding up?
Well, there are more demons around than before. I'd say people...
Is the demon blight really...
It's the worst it's ever been these past few...
In that case, it's more important than ever that we settle Eastgand.
Eastgand has had the least trouble with the demon blight. More importantly, there's room here for so many to settle.
So, you want to build a...
Yeah. I'm thinking of the area around Lake Pernia. It's high up.
Ready access to good fresh water is a big plus. The soil is rich there too. So be a good location for it.
All right. Me too. It won't be easy, but in this world, what is? Besides, I want to do my part.
Okay. Last thing we'll need is ladies.
Before we plan our town, we'll need to plan for...
Don't waste your time.
What?
No woman will fall for a guy who whines about needing love or romance to make something of himself. If you want proof, look no further than the icy glares these ladies here are giving you.
Oh, that's scorn.
Still, it'll be lonely there with just a bunch of guys.
Speak not of dreams. Become them. I read that in a book once. People are drawn to those.
In other words, find passion in something. And
a long time ago, I read that the secret. Okay, let's
do it. Oh, some of these monsters, either I just can't face them, or I missed my chance. I'm still confused when you say the leaderboards, but I don't mind that. We gotta get somewhere. Half of these things aren't even working. Are you so? kind of wonder if I did some of these side quests already. I don't think I have. Supposedly this one has like a giant troll next to it. I'm hoping that supposedly by doing it like this, I'm gonna open up the
another day without a wild penguin sighting.
Not good. They're still listless. I tried changing their feed, but with the weather what it is, the sea temperature has gone down. Maybe that has something to do with it.
Maybe so. I've been pulling up different fish around here lately too. And get this, I found a Kraken Queen in my nets the other day. Normally you only find them in the Northern Ocean.
Kraken Queen?
If this keeps up, Ysolt's fishing industry is in dire peril. We've got
fishermen and penguin farmers. We should all get together and have a meeting to figure out what to do.
By the way, you get smacked about by that Kraken Queen.
Oh yeah, those long whip-like tentacles did a number on me.
Oh man, lucky. I should take the boat out tomorrow, see if
I still don't get it, but as long...
Yeah, I think he was enjoying that whipping from the Kraken Queen a little bit too much.
Have you heard the rumors? People are saying there's a talking penguin around.
I didn't know penguins could talk.
It's true. Three people have already talked with it near the beach at night.
You don't say. We should totally try to capture it.
Well, this is no light matter here in Ysolt.
Local legend has it that when the end times come, a talking penguin... Everyone who's encountered this penguin...
Are you sure it's not just some demon?
It doesn't appear to be, though it does seem to be quite a... It goes after people, attacking them as it yells, I'm a met...
Is that supposed to be its...
I have no idea, but... What if
this is some kind of reverse psychology trick, right?
Yeah.
I can't sleep.
I'm with you. Some things do-
You're going to look for that talking-
What makes you say that? We're just going on a walk.
Look, Velvet! There's a penguin!
Think it might be the talking one?
Good evening. Lovely.
It really talked!
I can't believe it. Something I eat can talk?
Huh? Wait, do you guys eat us penguins too?
Why does it matter?
Please, answer my question. It's very important.
And I'll happily devour most anything if I have to.
Well then, I suppose you people are just like the others who came before. I can't let you keep doing that.
Oh, and what's a cutesy little penguin like you plan on doing about us, big bad humans?
Isn't this? I got a feeling. I got the strangest feeling that he came from another sales game.
Double hit! all stuck!
Why are my other stuff working? Why isn't my other stuff working? That's the thing I don't get. Blacked out. I don't understand why.
Back into a Pengyan. No matter.
Wait, why are you so intent on fighting us when you're outnumbered?
I have to protect my fellow Pengyans from the likes of poachers like you.
Poachers?
We're not poachers, I swear. We just came here to see a talking Pengyan.
Really? But then, why did you guys say you eat Pengyans?
Sorry, I guess we should have explained more clearly. This one will eat anything.
Yeah, sorry about that.
And as for me, the only pengyan I ever eat is what I buy properly at the market.
We're not good people, but we're not those kinds of villains either.
Oh, well, in that case, I should apologize for jumping to conclusions and picking a fight. I just ran into some pengyan poachers earlier. And I'm afraid I'm a little on edge right now.
Those must be the other people who've spotted you here. They're all sick in bed just from the shock of meeting you. Small fries like them. I bet they'll think twice before they try to poach another animal.
So, what are you then? Some special representative of Pengyan kind?
No, I'm Jude Mathis. I'm a medical student from Riza Maxia.
A medical student? From Rize Maxia?
It's in a different world from yours. Actually, I'm a human just like you all, but somehow I was flung into this dimension, and when I came to, I looked like this.
So, basically, you're a human from another world, but when you came here, it made you turn into a Pengyan?
This story of yours, quite a tale. The whole thing's pretty hard to believe.
It certainly is. However, when I was lost and confused, the Pengyans here were kind to me and took me in as their own. I wanted to repay the favor to them since they've done so much for me.
So you've been protecting them from any poachers who come.
But don't you have bigger things to worry about right now? Looks to me like you're too soft-hearted.
I get that a lot.
Well, we've heard your story. But even if it is true, it doesn't sound like there's anything we can do for you.
Don't worry about me. I'll figure out how to get home on my own, one way or another. The problem is that a friend of mine got sent to this world with me, but I haven't been able to find her. My hunch is that she's also turned into a Pengyan. You haven't heard of any other talking Pengyans, have you?
Can't say I have. Sorry.
Oh, okay.
What kind of person is this friend of yours? Maybe we'll run into her later.
Her name is Mila. She has pretty red eyes and long golden hair. She carries herself with dignity and possesses a commanding presence. What else? Oh, and one of her quirks is that whenever she sees something tasty, she drools.
That's an interesting quirk.
You mean she actually drools?
Also, she's known as the Lord of Spirits, because she's accompanied by four summon spirits with command over the elements.
Ooh, Lord of Spirits. How royal sounding.
Got it. If we hear anything, we'll let you know.
It may be hard, but try to keep your spirits up, Jude.
Thank you all so much. I hope you guys get a lead on Mila.
You care about her even more than yourself.
Well, how do I put it? She's just a really special person to me, I guess.
Fair enough.
That was a nice little cameo fight.
A talking penguin? No, that penguin, or rather, it's...
He said he came from another world. No matter how...
He's got guts, I'll give him that. It'd be nice...
He's kind to penguins.
If he was telling the truth, that would make him a castaway from another dimension. We seafarers...
Personally, I'm curious about this Mila girl. She might have a connection to the four Empyreans, or even Enominat himself.
Seems unlikely. Just in case, I'll keep everything Jude the Penguin told.
Alright, so we got that. So, I'm reading the, we'll walk through, and they want us to go to the terrace in the harbor. Let's see. Let's see where it says anything about a harbor. I wonder if they're somewhere else. Let me see. It's not telling you. Reading this thing is not... Apparently I'm missing something. Gotta go down here first.
I hear there's one really passionate Lady Teresa fan in Hellevis. But I'm not going to... Lady Teresa's true allure isn't in those frozen eyes. You can't say you understand her if that's all you see, but I do. Only I understand her true appeal.
Well...
Do you? Huh? Of course you do. Well, if you insist, I'll tell. Teresa's true allure is in that tinge of sadness hidden within her lovely face. Even when she's smiling, there's a touch of melancholy that never leaves her. It's like her heart is somewhere else, somewhere distant.
So where is it?
With her love, her true love, the true love she's yet to meet. How tragic. She suffers, lamenting the love she cannot find. That's why I watched over her so dearly. And then it happened.
What happened?
She was off duty, frolicking in the waves by Maclear Beach. That alabaster skin. How pure she looked in her swimsuit.
This guy is really creepy.
Yeah, seriously creepy.
Hey, what's with that cold look?
I feel bad for Teresa. She had to protect creeps like this guy, too.
What cold, cold eyes you have.
Velvet, Eleanor, quickly, avert your gaze! If you keep looking at him with disgust and disdain, you'll only stimulate this perverted freak!
Come on, everyone.
No, come back!
It's an interesting one. Very interesting.
Well, hello there. I heard you woke the four Empyreans.
What do you want, Morgrim?
I just came to pass on a little information to you. Specifically, that an Earth Pulse entrance has opened up. My guess is that it opened when you chased Innominaut out.
An Earth Pulse entrance.
We might be able to see more of the Earth in Historia.
Indeed. If we could learn more about Artorias's past, it might give us a hint about how to take on Innominaut.
That's just what she wants us to think. Anyone else smell a trap?
I don't think we have to worry about that.
Are you sure?
Shigure loathed any form of trickery. If Morgrim was that kind of Moloch, he would have struck her down long ago.
I appreciate your confidence in me. What you do with the information is up to you.
Where is this entrance?
It's at the Shrine of Tranquility, in Ebal.
You must have learned about this from the Abbey. Why pass it on to me?
No special reason. I just happened to think of Lord Artorias's Moloch. I thought it might be nice if I could help you learn a little more about her.
You mean Ceres?
All right.
So I rescued this poacher who'd run away from one of those Class 4 islands, right? She mentioned something about being hired by some chef to go hunt a rare wolf on the island. But she didn't see a single blasted critter on that island, let alone any rare wolf.
Then why did she run away?
Even though she never saw nothing, she kept hearing some beast howling round the island. When she got back to her boat, her food had been pilfered, and her ship was scratched up to hell. She got out of there as quick as she could. But her ship sunk soon as she hit open water.
Sounds like whatever's there is as smart and manipulative as it is.
Sounds like. Later I heard some talk about how several exorcists had gotten killed on that island. If you plan on going.
Thank you.
So we gotta head there now. I'll find this cat's to save my damn life. Not really showing me where it is. Looking for that Terrasheen Harbor place. Not even letting me know where it is. Hello, what do we have here? Oh, bottle. Thank you. Little lifeless spirit, its wings and soared to the skies.
Velvet?
Don't worry. I'm all right. I was just thinking of something that Celica liked to do whenever we passed a gravestone.
What was it?
I have a secret to tell you, she'd say. Then she'd hand me a flower and add, take it to the grave.
What? That's just a bad pun.
Exactly. Celica loved her puns. Nico's dogs are so cowardly that when a stranger comes by, they don't bark. They hide up on the woof.
Ugh. Feel like someone just broke my funny bone.
I always told her to stop with all the bad jokes. I thought they were so lame, but now that she's gone, I miss them. Every day with Celica was bright, filled with joy. I realize that now.
She'd be happy to hear that. You know, it sounds like Celica and Mogilu had a lot in common. If you're trying to say I'm an unrepunitent punster, I'd have to object. But if you're trying to say that I'm witty, charming, and the party mood maker, hey, Velvet, you can think of me as your new sister. I'll even let you call me Big Sis.
I'm this close to suing you for defamation of character.
I knew I'd see you in court one day. Judge, objection! This is a witch hunt!
You're incorrigible. Anyway, we don't have time to get all misty-eyed. Let's go.
All the way up there.
That definitely looks like an Earth Pulse entrance.
I don't sense Enominot here.
We still need to be careful. We might have ousted him from the Earth Pulses, but the four Empyreans are in play now.
If we want to learn anything useful, we'll need to go inside. Be ready for anything.
Oh snap, I don't want to know. Targets. Goodness, which one is this? I wonder if this is the wolf. It would be something if some of these were in like Earth Pulses in their respective areas. Which I think that just might be the case. So this one. Maybe that one. Maybe the wolf. Oh, it's the... What is this? I don't even think I got a head or something. Ain't beautiful from Hex and Isle. There's a red beast, but...
We will need to be extremely wary.
close one, but I am the victor.
Okay, I think I killed that one way earlier than I should have, regardless of the fact. We're almost there.
And with that, the oath is now formed. Cerys, take heed. I've now embedded a portion of the Arm formula within your corporeal form. Over the next several months, it should take hold and crystallize using the power of the oath.
The art you'll use to control the power my body has accumulated?
That is correct. Brunhild, the sorcerer's ring. It is an art that was lost long, long ago on this continent. Reviving it requires considerable investment.
So that is why you tied the oath to my life force. The formula will only be completed once I've died.
Do you have something to say?
No. I understand that this is a necessary step in order to realize armatization and bring Innominat under your control. And even though Siegfried possesses a similar power, Lord Melchior has yet to successfully locate the device. Knowing that, our research must be accelerated. That is the only reasonable way.
Then you understand. From here on, you are to focus on completing the Sorcerer's Ring.
As you say.
I trust you're not having any second thoughts about this?
She's a Moloch. Here to serve and nothing more. And today, she's proved herself quite loyal.
Yes. I am Cerys. I am your Moloch. I am simply a tool for you to fulfill your ideals. So Cerys took her oath to make armatization possible.
But what a heavy price to make her pay.
And Artorias did it knowing that she was his reincarnated wife.
Oh, who am I to talk? There was a time not long ago when I'd have done the same thing.
Regardless, things are now starting to come together. What happened to Cerys and to Eifried and Siegfried? It's all related. This all occurred so Artorias could armatize with Innominat and control him.
And then Velvet ended up devouring that power and making herself public enemy number one. How deliciously ironic.
No, Cerys knew what was going on, and she still...
But the Abbey has secured Siegfried's formula, and they're almost certainly using it to complete Innominat's armatus.
Let's keep going, Velvet.
Yeah. We've come too far to turn back now. I'll see this through to the end.
Yeah.
It's been a full century since Midgand reunited the fractured land. In that time, we've enjoyed a blissful era of peace and prosperity. But the world has also seen its faith and moral purity slowly decay, only to be supplanted by deep, profound sin. Things have gotten so bad that nobody has even realized that the four Empyreans now slumber. I'm entirely certain that demons will only become ever more rampant. And yet I'm powerless to stop it.
Empyreans? Demons? What are you talking about?
I'm sorry. You shouldn't have to hear me grumble. You've already done so much for me.
It's fine, really. You've seen so much of the world. Things that I never even knew existed.
Yes. I've seen mountains spew flame, and lands covered in ice. I've crossed stormy seas and ravines deeper than the eye can see.
That's so amazing. Weren't you ever frightened?
Of course. We are nothing in the face of nature. It takes so little for a person to lose their life out in the wilds. But in spite of the terror, those seas, the mountains, the forests, the deserts, they're absolutely breathtaking. And even in the harshest of climes, people still find a way to live there and carve out something resembling a home.
I think I understand you now.
How do you mean?
I can tell you really love this world. Not just that, but all the people who live in it, too.
The world and its people. Do you really think so?
I'm sure of it. Just remember that you are one of those people too, you know? You really should try to take care of yourself a little more.
I can't do anything right. How could I possibly learn to like myself?
I believe in you, Arthur. I mean, my family and I are already quite fond of you just the way you are, no matter your faults.
Thank you, Celica.
That was Velvet's sister and Artorias.
That's how I remember Celica. And him, too.
I see.
Lord Artorias.
Eleanor, I know that the Exorcists believe from the bottom of their hearts that their work will save everyone.
Perhaps. But that won't stop you from fighting them, will it?
No, it won't.
Isn't ignorance bliss? Should we really keep digging up the past like this?
Velvet's never been one to pick the easy road.
What's wrong, kiddo? I was just thinking. The Earth in Historia is supposed to be a vast record of world history. It could show us anything. So why does it only ever focus on events related to
Velvet?
It's
kind of breaking the fourth wall.
Perhaps it's reacting to her presence. Or maybe. Since this place used to be a Nominat's vessel, his power is still influencing what we're seeing.
If that were true, shouldn't you be able to control the Earth in Historia, kiddo? You're supposed to be part of Enominat. Think of all the juicy secrets we could dig out of the past! Oh, I'm getting pins and needles!
I'm not so sure. Having that much access might be frightening. Some things aren't so fun to learn about.
Bye-bye! hear that you've finally gotten your assignment. Have they given you a name yet?
Moloch number 2.
That isn't your name.
Huh?
You don't remember anything, do you? But of course you don't. You died before you were even born.
I...
But my memories... They came back. And these memories... They torment me. I can never replace them. And I can't undo them.
I don't really understand.
You don't have to. Just know that I was happier before my memories and free will reawakened. If I had one wish, I'd wish that you stay the way you are.
You're going?
I'm about to free someone who can kill the strongest Empyrean and the head exorcist. I suppose you could call it revenge. Against myself and against my past. Goodbye. Please, find it in your heart to forgive your mother when she failed to protect you.
Wait, what? How'd we get here? This is the prison island!
Probably by an Earth Pulse warp. I'll have to send for the Von Eltia to come get us.
I guess I must have met Ceres at some point, but... I don't have any memory of it happening.
But why would that place connect to here?
Well, I mean, this is an Earth Pulse point, isn't it?
Ceres might have willed it to be somehow.
What do you mean?
Velvet is right. I think the Earth in Historia showed us that memory because Ceres wanted us to see it. Or Velvet and Laffy said, at least.
I think I understand. And I think I agree.
It may have taken us all the way out here, but at least we have something to show for it. I suppose we can't complain.
Yeah.
This was worthwhile.
All right. Let's get to the harbor.
I can think and decide for myself now, but... It's kind of nice. I feel alive like this. So rest easy, Mom. I'll be okay.
Oh, this is... This is dope. I actually like this. More just the color variant. Is it? Alright, so... Keep telling me to go to this harbor, but I can't figure out for my life where the harbor is. Then go to the yeah, the harbor don't even exist. I don't know where to go to find the harbor. There isn't even any places that I haven't been. is this? Oh, man. Okay, I guess we can go to hell. I want to hell visa a different place. I gotta be honest, this, one place I'm looking for isn't really helping. Probably Heloise, I don't know.
You there, Exorcist! Do you know what happened to the Praetor, Lady Teresa? She used to be in charge here. Lady Teresa is the only one who can restore law and order in our town. Please, send a message to the Abbey. Tell them that the citizens of Helavis are awaiting her return. Even if the Lord of Calamity herself were to attack, I won't budge until Lady Teresa returns to us.
What will refusing to move accomplish?
If my life is in danger, I know Lady Teresa will come to save me.
Teresa won't be coming back.
What?
If you really love Teresa, you shouldn't rely on her to protect you. You should become strong enough to protect her.
Whoa, that burning glare of yours.
Wait, what?
Got some sickos, man.
We're planning evacuation routes. We need to be ready if the Calamity or demons show up in town.
When the Calamity attacked the first time, there was massive confusion. Some children got hurt and all. We're preparing evacuation boats so that we can all flee out to the sea if anything happens.
It's a good idea, but it will be hard to evacuate the entire town by boat.
That's a good point. But wouldn't a land route run the risk of being attacked by demons?
Yes. You'll need to guard it as heavily as you do the city gates. It would be best if you could devise a way to prevent demons from intercepting the escape route, but...
Some of the exorcists lost use of their malachi. We can't count on the Abbey's garrison.
I'll send a request for aid to the Abbey. But please, don't give up.
Of course. There's no way we'll give up.
Can you really ask the Abbey for help? I can send a Silvche to some of my old friends from when I was still in training. Even if they refuse to trust a traitor like me, they won't ignore the plight of...
How long are you going to sit there crying?
The demons that wrecked this town are still alive. Who knows when they'll show up again?
How about right now?
Sniveling idiot! Keep whining like that, and this calamity whatever will keep walking all over.
But what can we do? We can't even defeat a single.
That's why we take our boats, catch some fish, and make sure we've got enough food to keep on surviving. Didn't they drill anything into that fool head of yours in school? Get up and get the boat ready.
That is one hot-headed dad.
Too hot for any demons to get near. That's for sure.
Hey, Rokuro. I heard about a class 4 island that sounds damn near perfect for you.
An island that's perfect for me. Do the rivers flow with good drink?
Now that you mention it. But no, different island. I'm talking about you as a swordsman. The demons there all run around the island in suits of armor and helmets and stuff.
Armored demons are not unusual.
Yeah, but what I heard tell was that all the exorcists who got sent there came back with their swords broken. I don't know if they've got swords too, or if their armor's just that strong. But I reckon your sword will be able to stand up to them.
Well then, I've heard worse ideas.
If you believe the tales, that island used to be a place where swordsmen and knights competed to see who was stronger.
Oh yeah, I know the island you're craftsmen from all over gave their finest weapons and armor to the greatest of warriors. and made them fight. It was as much a showcase for those wares as it was a contest of strength.
So the demons on that island might come at us wielding fine arms and armor.
I'm certainly up for checking it out. I'm curious to see how good the stuff really is.
After all I've told you, you still want to go? What is wrong with you?
Boom. Assuming you get something for beating these things. Now, if I could just please just find where this damn island is. Let me go back to all of these. I don't see the place that they're trying to get me to go. Oh no, dude, I'm extra confused. Maybe this.
I take it you're a Bloodwing?
With all the turmoil, there's a lot of noise out there. So there was this skilled exorcist Praetor at the top of his game, yeah? Apparently, he got taken down by a Pinyon.
Oh? And how'd this pin-
I know it sounds like I'm pulling your leg, but I'm serious! The Praetor said the Pinyon attacked with arts of-
This must be how to get to Mila.
The four elements.
That's not all. From what I hear, this Pinyon sports red eye. They call it?
All right. So where is-
The attack happened in the Thigol ice caps. But I gotta warn you guys, Goldapin is said to be an ominous creature that signals the end of the world. Listen, I'm telling you this for your-
Why would you say that? Oh, no. So it's a Pinyon with red eyes, a gold-
They're calling her Goldapin.
I've seen a lot of things out there, but never anyone who has mastered all four elements, excluding myself, of course.
Whatever she is. If she's taken down a Praetor, she might be willing to work with us.
Or, you know, it could be a trap. This strengthens the case that she could be connected to the four Empyreans.
Either way, we should probably go and find out.
I'll send word to Jude and Isolde.
Hold on. That might complicate the situation.
We promised we'd let him know if we heard anything.
Fine. But I have my own way of...
Alright, so now we go to... Where the hell do we go? We go ice caps.
Thank you.
on down here. It's a little strong, so we might want to save.
Look! Red eyes? Golden coat? It's Goldapen, all right. And she's even got that quirk.
Be careful. If what we heard is true, she can use those four great spirits in battle.
See? She's drooling.
Does that mean she thinks we look tasty?
Does that mean she's a man-eating penguin?
Wait! Don't fight!
Hey! It's Jude!
No matter how much Mila loves to eat, she'd never attack a person without a good reason. Huh? Wait, this penguin isn't Mila.
Are you all right?
When I got your message, I ran all the way here without stopping to eat or drink.
That's enough. When will you people learn to leave this penguin alone?
And there she is.
Hunting for food, I could understand. But I won't allow you to take this creature's life on some flimsy notion of bad omens. If you want the penguins, you'll have to fight me first!
Who the hell are you?
I'm Mila Maxwell, and I'm the protector of penguins.
Make it real!
So did I say?
You're strong. You know your way around a sword.
As do you. I can see that Jude wasn't exaggerating when he called you the Lord of Spirits.
Jude? Do you know him? I've been looking all over for him.
He's right there.
Oh, Jude! Thank goodness. I'm so glad you're safe.
Mila. You can tell it's me?
Of course I can. You're a lot smaller on the outside, but you're still you on the inside.
Thanks, Mila. That being said, I haven't exactly had an easy time in this form.
Yes, I can see how it might have given you some trouble. Leia and Elise would probably be worried sick, and Alvin would tease you mercilessly.
I think there's a way I can change back. When I fought these guys before, I was somehow able to do it.
You fought them? So they really are a bunch of no-good Pengeon abusers.
We're not, I swear. It's all a misunderstanding.
It's okay, Mila. They're the ones who told me where to find you, and they're not Pengeon abusers.
Oh, all right then. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to go jumping to the wrong conclusions about you.
Didn't jump.
Everyone, thank you so much for reaching out to me.
No need to thank us. We just did the same as anybody would.
I'm glad you found your friend.
However, both of you are still stuck here.
It's fine. The two of us will figure something out. We'll get Jude back to his normal self and find our way home to Risa Maxia.
Yeah.
Oh, do you want to come along too?
You know this Pengyon?
Yeah, for some reason I've taken quite a liking to him. Something about him just feels familiar.
I suppose so.
They're gone. Is it really okay to let them leave?
What do you say, Aizen? Do you think Mila is connected to the Empyreans?
No. Her arts felt fundamentally different from the ones we Malakim use.
Agreed. I think I might actually believe they came from another world.
In that case, we can let them be. Since she took down that exorcist, I don't think we need to worry about her joining forces with the Abbey.
Yeah, but couldn't she still join our side?
I wonder. I feel like she might be a bit out of our league.
I don't know. I think you two have more in common than you care to admit.
We should leave them be. Besides, if they came with us, Eleanor might try to eat Jude.
I would not!
Where's the wolf? I wonder if by doing these, we're going to end up getting the other code reds that we're having a hard time finding. They should say something about you having a... Alright, whatever. Alright, so that's another one down. Now we need to head to Malicio. I wish I knew where the hell they were talking about. We need to head to Malicio, wherever the fuck that is. I'm gonna just try to find it. I'm assuming they mean Mauricio, because they have it pronounced Malicio. The guy, and I'm just going by what it sounds like. It sounds like Mauricio, so that's where we're headed. We're headed to Mauricio. Because I need to find out what the hell of these. They didn't even translate this stuff right. They got a Heloise on here, but it's pronounced Heloise. I don't understand it. Supposedly we got
with the Abbey told me about this one weird Class 4 island. Some exorcists went there, and when they came back, they were laid up in bed, having awful nightmares and saying strange things in their sleep.
What sort of things?
Stuff like the walls moving and attacking them. Fairies flying in front of them.
Couldn't those just be demons they saw there?
Hey, I ain't done. Towards the end...
They hated Bax?
I don't know.
Maybe they saw the back of some demon on...
Your guess is as good as mine.
Alright.
Kamawana's come down with a fever.
What?
I've been tending to her, but it just won't go away. She just keeps mumbling over and over about how she doesn't want to take her mom's medicine.
Kamawana.
We've heard her talk about her mom's medicine before, haven't we?
I gather that it's something her mom used to make her take whenever she came down with a cold.
It might be something specific. If there's any left, it would be back at her old house in Haria, right?
Probably. I don't know if it'll work now that she's a Therian, but I'll go and try to find it.
You'll do no such thing. I'm sorry, but the Abbey's still looking for you, and there's no way I'm about to hand you over.
Don't try to stop me, Velvet.
Look, we'll go to Haria. You stay here and take care of Kamawana.
Eleanor.
Velvet, if you try to fight Medissa, it won't end well. And I would back her up, too.
Look, if we have time to argue about this, we have time to go find that medicine ourselves.
Yeah, I guess you're right.
Thank you.
Eleanor, why are you going so far out of your way for Kamawana?
After my mother was taken from me, I found myself an orphan of the Abbey. I grew up figuring that I'd probably become a nun and spend my life in mourning. But on the night of the Advent, my inner resonance awakened. I honestly believed that I had been given the power to change the world for the better, you know? Less sorrow,
exactly.
Less suffering. But even after I donned the mantle of the exorcists, I was still pathetic, full of ideals, but so ignorant of the way things really work. That ignorance is what drove me to go after Mahina and take her away from Kamawana. I can't change the past, but at the very least, I can atone. I'd do anything to give her a chance.
All right then. She's in your hand.
We'll be as quick as we can. What? What was that? I just...
Oh, feels.
Lafayette?
Yeah, it's just... I don't know how to explain it. It's like something dark dug itself into my chest. Eleanor's the same as always, right, Rokuro?
Yeah, same old fired up at least, that's what she projects.
Dude, that's a cheap project. What type of subtitle? They did a bum job on these subtitles. Oh, man, that's horrible.
To decipher what the ancient book had to say about Inominat's awakening, didn't you?
Right after we escaped from Titania, yes.
Oh, come on, Grim. I'd say it turned out all right.
That's not for you to decide.
You're not seriously blaming Grim for all that.
No, I'm not. But I'd still like to know anything more specific about Inominat.
Please, tell us what you've learned.
All right. What Inominat means to fully awaken isn't a large quantity of malevolence, but rather the quality of it, in 8 types. Specifically, he needs despair, hatred, greed, conceit, lust, obsession.
If each was assigned to a single Therian, then Velvet would be hatred and Kamawana greed, right?
Medissa would be conceit, Teresa is lust, and Orthrus, obsession?
And cowardice for Griffin. That leaves the Rhino Stagros with selfishness.
But Artorias was trying to steal despair from me. How does that fit in? 8 types of malevolence and only 7 Therians. Whatever the case, it seems obtaining this 8th malevolence is the final obstacle before Inominat's full awakening.
I see. That would certainly explain Artorias' behavior. His plan was to foster profound hatred within Velvet, before plunging her into despair.
And he used her brother to do it.
If that's true, gathering all the Therians served a greater purpose. Right now, the Abbey has no means to collect despair.
But with Teresa dead, shouldn't a new Therian have taken her place?
Yeah. But after we killed her, the Abbey still went out of their way to try to capture me. That must mean they haven't been able to secure the new Therian. And even if they did, it wouldn't have despair.
That's a good point. Artorias spent 3 long years trying to foster the despair within. If that is indeed the specific type of malevolence Enominat needs, it must not be something one can find overnight.
Right. We need to attack while there's still time.
Indeed.
Is something troubling you?
Yes. It comes down to the very... When you talk about the relative quality of... That would mean that Therians pick out and devour...
Yeah.
But malevolence by its very nature is... They'd need to be responsive to a purity of im...
So we don't need to worry so much?
Oh, but I think I know someone who fits that description. Perhaps a certain succession of top exorcists who have tried to suppress and purify the spread...
You don't mean...
It's just a concern. For now.
Alright, so we got that, Yeah, I kind of beat this one before I even had a chance to even get it assigned to me. So we still got 3 more. They're probably going to pop up soon. Alright, so... because that's supposed to be the next person we're supposed to fight for the side. Go to Melchior, take the east exit and proceed to the south. Okay. Here goes the monster we were looking for. Thing up above us. Thank you. Alright, we're gonna go to Hari then. How the hell are we supposed to leave? No, I know they don't plan us on this. I was gonna say, I know they didn't plan on us, like. Never mind.
Did you hear that Moloch they were doing experiments on finally broke?
Yeah. You mean the one where they were trying to combine multiple smaller Molochim into one giant Moloch?
Wow, it turns out it not only looked like a freak, but its shackled mind snapped, leaving...
Huh? Guess they'll have to...
Yeah. For now, they've moved it out to the Faldi's ruins. They're repurposing it as a test target for a new Moloch art and development.
At least we'll be able to get some valuable data out of it.
Using Molochim for their own...
I hope you're not thinking of doing any...
Oh? Like what?
Like thinking about bringing mercy to a broken...
What I think is necessary and what actions I take are for me...
Aizen! That exorcist said they were using the Moloch to get data. If it were complete, they could use it against us. Stopping that wouldn't be a waste of our time, would it?
You think you know just what to say to me, don't you?
I'm just stating the truth.
Just so we're clear, we're not going to rescue it.
No argument here.
I'm assuming that's how we get to... I probably still gotta get to. Gotta finish this Kamawana ones before we. Kamawana's side quest before we, get to. That Code Red. I'm mad they want you to manually do all of this, like you can't fast travel. At this point in the game, you should be able to fast travel anywhere you damn well please.
thinking of going this way.
And why is that?
A real nasty demon's taken root. It's a huge troll with a big old...
Did you say... You didn't happen to hear if the troll was wearing a large jewel, did you?
Yeah. I hear the greedy beast's been going...
It's... that demon.
Okay, whatever. Then we're going to fight it.
Hey, Lafayette's your partner. I don't care if you keep secrets from the rest of us.
You're right, Roker. That's okay. Well, I think the demon that Bloodwing mentioned could be one that attacked.
Is that when you got...
It was when a group of giant trolls descended. They were after a jewel housed in our shrine.
Same name as you.
It means light. The jewel shone brilliantly, even when it turned the attack.
Question is, do I really want to hear this?
She died.
I see. So if the demon possesses this Eleanor jewel, you'll...
And that it's responsible...
Exactly.
If you want Velvet, but you know Velvet.
Knock yourselves out. Just so... This thing, you talk of avenging your...
My mother said, stay strong and keep living. Right now, my first priority...
Hey, what up? But I better not...
I have to be strong.
Did that weird feeling just...
Yeah.
I wonder, did... I don't know, I thought they would have gave him, like, doors that were similar to, what he had at the end of the story.
I'm not seeing any of those demons we heard about.
Let's look for the medicine while we can.
Hey, this is what we're looking for?
I think so.
Hey, there's a note attached to it too.
A note?
No, it's more like directions on how to administer it. This medicine is extremely bitter. If she develops a fever while I'm away, you need to do specific...
Look, it's wearing...
That's... it.
Then this must be what killed Eleanor!
Oh, Eleanor! Go give her some help!
I think she can hear you right now.
All we can do now is help her fight.
Form second! Double haze! Double haze! Armor crushing!
Double haze!
Driving you.
I suppose you're right. But if this is truly a part of me, I can't help but empathize with Kamoana. If she ever found out the truth of what I did to her mother, I know exactly how she'd feel. She'd want to kill me.
I don't know about...
I keep telling myself I did it for her own sake, but I'm horrible. If Kamoana ever attacked me, maybe I'd end up killing her too.
That's not who you are!
It is exactly who I am! And besides... Kamoana is only alive because she ate her own mother! I have a hard time believing that any salvation awaits someone like her!
Of course.
You've been carrying this pain for a long time.
My mother told me to stay strong and keep living. I'm only here right now because she sacrificed her life, and yet I'm selfish. I'm so sorry, Kamoana!
This is bad. She's exuding malevolence.
No! Don't try to carry the burden all by yourself!
If we don't do something, Lafayette's going to lose his vessel.
It's fine. Let her spill it all out.
Imbecile! Without a vessel, he'll turn into a dragon!
Method 1. Wrap the medicine in sweet starch paper. This only works about half the time.
Usually she just eats the paper and spits the medicine back at you. Method two, mix it in with her meals without telling her. It tends to make the food bitter. I think she's catching on. It's gotten harder to trick her and she may refuse to eat. Method three, pinch her nose and force her to swallow it. But be very careful. She will struggle and try to bite. You don't want to lose a finger.
Is this really the time?
Is that... Yes. It's the one Mahin. Her duties must have often taken her away. Someone else had to watch Kamuana.
Her fevers are caused by mental distress, but for some reason she believes that these bitter berries are medicine. If she takes one, her mind will stop racing and she will calm down. I realize that this is an awful lot to ask, but she can be awfully stubborn. But deep down, she's please. Please do what you can for her. I can't thank you enough for your help.
I didn't realize that her mother was...
Yeah, it looks like her mom had a bit of a forceful streak with her, doesn't it?
Nobody's a saint in this world, not even our own mothers. If they need to, they'll lie and use force. You do absolutely whatever it takes to protect your child.
The resolve. To protect your child.
Well, Eleanor, have you calmed down now?
Yes. I apologize for my behavior.
So, what are you going to do?
I guess... no. I'll make sure she takes the medicine. I swear, she will get better.
Do whatever you feel.
All right, get a move on, guys. Let's hurry back to Kamuwa.
Fee, are you home?
I'm fine. It's Eleanor I'm worried about.
She'll manage.
That woman takes no half measures. She will get through this.
Yeah.
All right, so after this, we ought to be able to go face that free ice cap thing.
Guys.
What?
This is serious. Kamuana's gone delirious from her fever. She turned into a Therian.
Where's Medissa?
She used herself as bait to lure Kamuana away and keep anyone... They look like they were headed for Mount Killerouse, but I'm not sure how long Medissa...
We need to go after that.
Are you all right with me taking...
Yes.
This is how we can go to the Gellerberg ice fields. Pretty sure that's how we the blood spray and crystal. I'm pretty sure that's how we get to it. Probably still gotta beat the side quest in order to make it. Let's see where this takes us.
Kamawana, honey. It's okay. You can eat me if you need to. If it means you'll go back to your...
Stop!
Kamawana, I've got your mom's...
You're lying!
It's true. Your mom heard you had a fever, so she sent us this medicine to give to you.
No! I hate it!
It's okay. It's not bitter. Your mom figured out a way to make it sweet. Just for you.
I don't believe you! You're lying! Lying!
It's true. Here, see?
You lied to me.
I know, I know. Kamawana's fever has finally broken.
Well, that's one crisis averted.
Eleanor, I couldn't have done this without...
I was just following your example.
You're really prepared to pull out all the stops for her.
I am. I don't know how this will all end up. I may be weak, but as long as I can...
You already seem pretty strong to me, Eleanor.
Seriously?
What? It's the parts you don't think about that are the strongest.
That doesn't even make sense!
A mother's not ever going to be that hard on her child, no matter how they turn out. Mothers just want their children to be well, and to live a happy life. I'm sure that's what yours meant for you.
You think?
Sounds right to me.
If you ever become a mom yourself, you'll understand.
I can't say I plan on it right now, but... duly noted. Eleanor! What's wrong? Why is your face all red? Is it? It's just...
We're just having a little girl talk amongst ourselves. You're free to join if you like, though.
What? No thanks!
Maybe I shouldn't have teased him.
I may not be a mother, but I think I do understand. When I'm around, strong or weak, level-headed or all kids deserve to have a good life.
Grimoire, could we talk?
You sound so serious.
Well, isn't it?
Getting caught up in the moment is for young, foolhardy lovers. So, what is...
I just figured I should drop by since...
Ugh, you're talking like you're...
It's just that we're up against... Even Miss Mogilu doesn't know what the future holds for us!
Whether she has it figured out or not, it is our lot in life to follow our vessels and fight to the...
That's what I've always thought, so I just dealt with Miss Mogilu's craziness up till now. She's never thanked me for it! No, good job. It'd be nice to hear a little...
Surely you know she's not the type to do...
That's all the more reason to want just one brief clip!
If you're so unhappy, it's not too late to switch back to the Abbey's side and become an informant again.
What's the point in that? I don't know anything they'd want, and they wouldn't have any use for me there.
So you lack confidence in your own abilities?
Miss Mogilu has let me come with her wherever she went, and her talents have gotten us this far. But now that we have to fight Enominat, I'm worried. I don't know what use I can be for her, or if I can keep her safe.
But you'll still go, won't you?
Yeah, of course! Or else my name isn't Norman Brave!
See? You've been keeping Mogilu safe this whole time. With all the emotional pain she's been through, she's needed someone as thick-skinned and tenacious as you. She may talk like she doesn't care, but she wouldn't have tracked you down and renewed your pact if she didn't.
When you put it like that, the end!
That's right. You just trust in old Norman therapist's good advice.
Wow! I'd have never expected... you'd actually make a joke like that.
I just thought I'd get caught up in the moment like you wanted.
Oh, we could probably go fight Zavid, wherever he may be. That's cool. I like that.
Kamoana, has your...
It has, and it's all thanks to you.
But now there's something extremely... You sound really serious.
I want you to open my treasure chest with me.
A treasure chest?
Well...
Treasure, of course.
But it's a really...
How important are we talking here?
I totally would. It's a...
Well, if it's that important, then I...
Yay!
Where's the treasure chest, then?
On some ice?
Next time, you should probably leave it somewhere a little safer, Kamoana.
Oh! And you can't open it without...
This is getting more comp...
Well, if you leave a treasure chest unlocked, you're just...
Okay.
Do you remember where the key is?
It's in Guile's pocket. I slipped it in while he was sleeping.
Yeah, I don't like...
What else was I supposed to do? It's a...
Yeah, I know.
All right, let's go hunt down Dai. Good luck.
What the hell, Guile? Wait, this is all the way up here.
Why couldn't I be a salamander?
Don't move, Dial. We're going to search.
What? Why?
No figures. He must have dropped it somewhere.
What are you all talking?
Kamoana says she hid the key to her treasure chest in...
Seriously?
I just figured that if anybody tried to steal it, you'd like...
I'm so...
Any idea where you might have dropped it?
Wait, it might have been when I was drying my shirt back at the inn. I think I heard a clink of...
Wait, when it was drying? Don't you know to check your...
Come on, I'm a bachelor. You're expecting way too...
Well, I guess we should check the inn.
Meaningless run around. I understand they try to make things fun, but some of this stuff is just useless. Useless dialogue.